back, guys. This is Dominguez John, the motherfucking building. I was thinking with six heads. I haven't done an intro in a little while. You know, been getting headaches and a lot of situations in my life, but it's okay. I'm here. I'm happy. I'm here with the crew. I'm here with the gang. We're here with some beautiful women on this beautiful day. It's Dominguez John. On my left side, we got Miss Soli. What's her at name?
@styles_by_soli.
If you want to look flawless, you better hit up fucking Soli. No bullshit.
She does beards as well, you know, for the bald headed motherfuckers out there.
She makes everyone look flawless.
On my right side.
AKA, I call her Magic Hands.
There's a reason why he calls her Magic Hands.
Completely different from what we're talking about. Hopefully, we don't call her Magic Hands. On my right side, we have Mr. Inspire Motivate. You already know how it goes. Millions of views on Instagram.
Yeah, I just want to say
no other platform.
I just want to say shout out to me for keeping the monthly chatter alive, cuz
without
these guys, we wouldn't even have a monthly chatter. But keep going on, keep going
without these girls, either.
I saved the monthly chatter once, remember?
I think I saved it this week.
You've never saved it. You almost canceled it.
I was on it.
That's a great.
Go to AJ.
I don't want to skip AJ. Let's go all the way to the bottom, all the way to the corner. What we got in the corner? Who's that?
Destiny, what's up?
Destiny's gonna talk into the mic this time. She didn't talk to the mic last podcast. And then we have Mr. Rivera in the building. No one gives a fuck about him. His nipples are out. Gay. But we appreciate him because it's 2023.
I'm inspired by DJ, you know? He be walking out, you know?
He did say that last week.
I did say that. I said, you know what? I'm inspired by him. I'm gonna start wearing fucking robes and shit.
That's not a robe.
I know it's not.
Are you inspired or turned on?
Oh, whoa.
Ooh.
My fault. Ladies first.
I might have been both.
Ladies first.
Ladies first. You ain't got shit for us?
I guess
so.
Come on. You got
and
shit.
And the podcast.
We'll
see you next time.
Yeah, I'm like,
you got something.
Oh, no. Sure. No.
Talk your shit.
That was a question, so I said ladies first.
Go ahead. Let it rip.
Okay, you guys start.
You start. Girl,
I'll start
first.
Oh, there you go. Soli.
All right, and I definitely want to attack AJ with this question.
Damn, AJ, everybody's on you today.
I do not like headphones.
Yeah, so like, AJ, ever since Nuestra closed, where you be at?
Oh, that's a great question.
Inside, like a sad boy. Natalie, I miss you.
Shout out to Natalie.
I miss you. Nah, no bullshit. I woke up one day hungover as fuck, and I was like, damn. I try to like Grubhub Nuestra, because I didn't even want to leave my crib.
Was that a sad moment when you realized it's no longer open?
Yeah, it's gone.
Yeah, that's sad.
But you know what? She's still doing catering events. Shout out to Natalie Rodriguez. She's doing motherfucking catering events, so you can still get some Nuestra fire as long as you catering.
Mm. All right, I got it.
I'm
going to jump with a question with the podcast. I want to know from the ladies first, what do you guys think is the worst place for a guy to get a woody?
Worst place? Definitely church.
Anytime. No, I feel like...
Your school.
I want to hear from the girls. What do they think?
Oh, shit.
I would agree with Soli, church.
Church? I would say anytime.
How about the guys?
My opinion is...
A funeral, that's so deep.
My opinion is getting a woody...
You open the casket and you get a woody? That's right. You got to leave.
My opinion is...
You got your daughter's play?
Is that any place that they don't want it. That's a bad woody.
Sounds aggressive.
I'm
saying if she did not try to fuck at that point in time, it's a bad place to get a woody.
I'll fuck in church.
I mean, a lot of us would. But who's to say that she's like, yeah, I'm trying to fuck with you. Like, you know, sometimes that head thinks before this head. And it's like.
But are you getting
hold on. So going off of that, do you guys give the same dick to every girl?
Absolutely not.
You sent a video, remember?
Absolutely not. No. Absolutely not. My thing about
it
is...
comes with love.
All right, so here's the thing. You got to feel shorties out. My opinion, personally...
There's no test drive.
No, there is. My thing about it is, if you got it like that, you could afford to do this. If you don't got it like that, then you obviously can't. But if you get some D+, some C-, some C+,
Toto?
Right? No, I'm talking about dick. You get some D+.
You have D- dick?
C-, C+, dick... Right?
Are you talking from a girl's perspective?
Hold on. No, I'm talking about from a nigga's perspective.
What right? Nigga's getting D- dick?
Hey, what happened to the N-word?
But if you got it, but hold on. But if you got it like that, if you got it.
How you gonna say the N-word and this guy's talking about you're getting D- dick?
Hold on. But if you got it.
You get D- dick, my boy?
Hold on. But if you got it like that, your D plus is shorty's B-, A-. Like, you never know. If you got it like that. My point is, you have to feel shorty out. I gotta know if I dick you down and I give you this D+, C-, and you're not gonna act like a psychopath after, then all right, cool. I could step it up. I could step it up a notch. My thing about it is you always have to have something in the reserves in case Shorty becomes your wifey. Because then how do you spruce?
How do you make her wifey if you're not giving her hubby dick?
Bro, what you mean?
If you got it just gets better later on,
that's
right?
That's what I'm saying. If you got it like that,
so you give
got
a whack
like
dick
that,
from
bro.
The beginning?
Nah, you're saying, I'm not saying whack
then
dick.
Then she falls in more in love.
Exactly. No cap.
Once in a blue, you might do it back.
Your D plus C minus might be a dude's A plus. Facts. Like, you never know.
Or a dude's F, but who knows?
You're talking about sex game.
I'm just saying.
Not just D.
I'm just saying you gotta leave something in the reserve, because if she don't act crazy, if she don't act up, then you know, all right, cool, I could step it up a notch.
So you'll end up in a cage?
Well said, AJ.
You know, you never fuck with a shorty. Right, I know you haven't, because you're Mr. like fucking simp, only fucking relationships type shit. But I know the real niggas around here, you know damn well that you don't fuck some shorties that you didn't mean to make fall in love with you.
Who the fuck
you
talking to?
That you didn't mean to make fall in love with you, that fell in love with you.
Has that always been like your thought process, or did it change?
Nah, it changed. So I'm gonna give you the exact time when it changed.
The AJ podcast.
So when I was in college, I went to one of my uncles. My uncle, man, this man is. Yo, shout out to my uncle. This man is 53
please.
Years old. I'm not going to give his name.
Yeah,
he's like 53 years old.
Goddamn.
Still dating, 20 years old, doing his thing. But I told him, like, yo, these girls be telling me don't fall in love and blah, 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 blah. And we're just going to be fuck buddies and this, this, and that. And for some reason, like, I got a few that, like, hate me right now because I don't want relationships. And she was like, I'm gonna tell you, nephew. He's like, you can't give Binga Dulce.
That's where it started.
To everybody. He's like, you gotta know when to
do it. I thought it was your grandpa.
No, it was my uncle. Shout out to you. You know exactly who you are. And from that day forward, I never looked at shit the same. I was like, all right, bet. So some girls is getting this, some girls is getting this, some girls is getting this, and you know it might excel.
How do you say sour
but
in
my,
Spanish?
My thing about
sour?
It is, my thing about it is, nah, in your opinions, I want no girls' opinions. We've been together 5 years, 7 years, 10 years. If I gave you everything I got when we first started dating, then what spruces the relationship up? What keeps it fresh?
Experiment.
Trying. You know,
new things, yeah.
Try new, okay, cool. But guess what? We don't have to try new things yet. If I didn't give you everything I got when we first.
So how long does it take you to give everything you got?
Right.
You're about to die.
So you bend over on the first
What's
night.
What's the time frame?
Yeah, because I'm like, yo, we're married 10 years. Say, you gave me everything, but we're still together 20 years down the line.
I would say it would also depend. It depends, not just on the time frame. It depends on the girl. If you're not stressing me, if you're not acting crazy, if you're not fucking bugging the fuck out. I'm obviously gonna step it up each and every time.
We know you got whack pussy, bro.
I would say like, you know, when you could really give that A plus wifey dick, I say like 2 years in.
And 2 years?
That's long.
Of whack
Damn,
pussy?
2 years?
No. I don't think it's whack. I just think like his full potential.
I'm talking about full potential. Like
I'm doing some
cartwheels in that pussy.
That's what I'm saying. I told you.
Full potential.
I'm backed up in that shit.
And backflip.
Deep strokes, hard strokes, soft stroke, all sorts of random shit. Eat you from the back, the
front,
the side.
So do you ease into it or just like, bam, 2 year anniversary, you got everything?
Yeah, I mean, I slowly, gradually ease into it.
I'll tell you what he does. He gets naked. He does a cartwheel. Goes back
in.
Hops
in the cage.
It's a slow, gradual ease. Like, especially if you're one of them dudes that can make yourself come on demand. Like, you could really just finesse your way into shit.
All right, next question. Who has it?
I do have another question. Oh. So, I seen this debate on Facebook, and it was pretty much about how loyalty is lost in today's generation. Do you guys agree with that?
I'm a loyal man. They can't have me though.
Yeah, I think you just gotta find the
in friendship. I don't think
loyalty is lost. I just think with social media and a lot of people being more out there than they normally would be, I think that we're finding out about a lot more different types of relationships.
So it's, it could be more public now, like
polygamy and all these different types. Like, I scroll on TikTok and I might see like. Why cheat when you can have two of us? And then the hashtag will be like polygamy or polyamory, whatever the fucking shit is.
Yeah, hold on. Last time we seen Mrs. Destiny. You told us some crazy story. about your love life. So how's the love life going?
I'm having fun. I'm enjoying myself. I'm as single as the word. I'm just doing me, and I'm happy. I'm happy now.
So what's your opinion on loyalty in this generation?
Since you're single, what do you think?
I feel like loyalty comes within, like, you. Even when it comes to friendship, like, if you're loyal to somebody, you stick with that person regardless, no matter what. If you know how to communicate, if something's wrong, you know, your loyalty stands where you and that person could communicate and be like, all right, well, this is, you know, what bothered me, whatever. Any situation. It doesn't even have to be sexual. I just feel like if I'm loyal to you, you're loyal to me. And if you automatically are not loyal to me, it's cool. I know where I stand in your life. You know what I'm saying?
I got a legitimate question for the ladies.
Uh-oh. What's up?
I don't know if y'all are religious. Are you religious?
I believe in God.
Okay, you believe in God? You religious? Obviously, I know slowly be going to church. So my question is, why in the Bible did every man have more than one wife? Every man. From Moses.
I'll ask my pastor Joseph. And I'll get back to you.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm not good.
Pastor,
I haven't even read the Bible.
So my question is that a new age thing? Is that a new age thing where, because there's a lot of religions that still do that to this day. I'm talking 4, 5, 6 wives, like, no big deal. Did America make that a culture? Did America make it where it's only supposed to be one wife?
Man made it, I think.
No,
because, I mean, if you look at it, like, I mean, how many people in the Bible had 13 plus, 15 plus kids with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 wives? There's a lot of people in the Bible you could think of that did that. So that's my question is,
Dumb. Me, I ain't sharing. I ain't sharing my man. My man's not sharing me, period.
Who's them?
Huh? So the people in the Bible, babe.
So my question is, if your man was like, babe, let's spruce shit up, let's have a threesome, you like,
it's not happening.
Not happening.
And I hope he respects that.
Okay, I respect it. Okay. What about you? You with the shits?
I mean, if I'm not in a relationship, then
we're no. You and your man is you and your man. And he, one day he's like, babe, let's fuck shit up. Let's spruce it up. Let's change something up. Let's invite. I'll let you pick the shorty.
Yeah, after the 2 years.
You pick the shorty and we could have a little threesome. You still not with the shit.
What if she's like, babe, it has to be another guy. It can't be another shorty.
Yay.
Then that's not a threesome. That's a train.
Gay.
She says, I'll only suck his dick.
Gay.
Nope. It's crazy. Do you see, that's crazy to me.
Who's agreeing with
it's
that?
It's not crazy.
It is crazy.
It's not crazy because y'all two could see each other naked and there would be no fucking big deal. Us three cannot see each other naked. It would be a fucking big deal.
It wouldn't be with someone you know.
It is a little bit different with guys because a girl, I don't know, I look at shorties like,
I know y'all be looking at shorty's asses and be like, damn, that shorty got it.
Oh, always. Always.
Okay.
I don't think we have that for guys.
Yeah, we don't ever look at a guy and be like.
So when guys wear gray sweatpants, you don't like, damn, his dick imprint is there. You guys don't do that? I'm just asking. I don't know. I'm asking.
We think it's automatically fake. I see some shit the other day.
All right.
He said, is that a banana in your pocket?
No.
Hold on.
Bro, if you're, no, wait, no, shut up.
Waist down on
first
a man.
Of all, put your mic up a little bit. And then second of all, if you're on Instagram and you post a fucking 12-inch all the way down your leg, you're fucking putting a plátano down there, bro. You don't have a 12-inch soft shit down your leg.
Never heard of elephantitis?
Never heard of el negro de WhatsApp?
Wait, what?
What?
I hope Fidel doesn't know what that means. And we skip that comment for this bitch.
What's a catabix to berry?
I'm just saying, when the Instagram photo comes out and there's 8, 10, 12, 14 inches down, all the way down to the knee on the Instagram post, it's fake.
I never seen an Instagram post. I have a question. For the ladies, would you rather have a grower or a shower?
A grower.
All right.
I don't want all these ladies looking at his imprint.
So there's a grower and a shower. So for example, just hypothetically speaking, right? You could have a dude who's, let's just say, 5 inches soft, but when he's hard, he's 6 inches, right? Then you could have a dude 2 inches soft, but when he's hard, he's 8 inches.
So one, when the dick is flaccid, it's big, and then it just grows a little bit. The other one
grows like
more.
Maybe like an inch or so. But the other one, when it's flaccid, is mad small, but when he's hard, he's like fucking Superman.
So you want a shower? You want his pee-pee to be big and then get a little bigger?
So you don't want the small, then gets like really, really big.
You didn't say
it's
really,
not empty.
Really big.
I mean,
it's not open.
Is 8 inches not big?
You're messing with this guy that's like 9 inch.
All right, so for example,
cool with him just
I'm giving an example.
Or soft.
All right, so soft. This guy is 5 inches soft.
Okay.
But when he's hard, he's 6 inches, right? Okay, hold on.
That's
you got a guy. Then you got a guy who's 2 inches soft, mm-hmm. but when he's hard, he's 8 inches.
That's me.
That's a grower.
That's a grower. You want the grower.
It don't matter. At the end of the day,
size don't matter.
Everyone said it. It doesn't. Yeah.
Not everyone. Because we've had a very
people have said it matters.
What? Mad people on this podcast.
We had a viral clip here.
Literally, hold on. I'm just telling you right now.
It don't matter.
It don't matter.
The ones who say size don't matter are still losing on this podcast because there's been mad girls who said size matters.
No, there's more girls.
No, more girls said it doesn't matter.
You said it yourself on the pod.
Size matters because when it really comes down to it, they be like, "Oh my God, it's too big." Like they be frightened.
Yeah. Like, then I feel like shorties do it for clout. Exactly. Size matters.
Yeah.
It does not. It does the work. If you're feeling the person, you got a vibe going on.
Right.
And his pee-pee's not that big, but.
Yo, no, let's.
Love
let's,
matters.
Let's get to that conversation. Okay. Let's get to that conversation. No. Pee-pee? It's. No, hold on. When, how do you call it? Girls be in love with a guy, and then, you know, they have sexual intercourse, whatever. And then they're like, oh my God, it was amazing. Then the dude breaks her heart. And then the next day, she's like, oh, his shit was whack.
Yeah, she's fine.
I hate that
she's
shit, fine. Yeah.
But like, why do girls do that is my question.
She's a lame-o. What do you mean? She's immature. She's immature because I'm going to tell you something. If I had a good dick, it's good forever and ever. If it's lame, you don't know how to fuck.
Forever.
If the dick made it on the Facebook post, it was fire.
If it's good, even if we didn't make it or whatever, or we don't even talk, right. It was good. You got that. But if it wasn't good, then... It's not good.
What do you guys think about?
Could you be with somebody that it wasn't good?
No.
What do you guys think about?
Because
those?
Then that makes me feel like I'm.
What is not good I'm dick though?
Yeah. All right, but here's the thing.
And that's the thing. Oh, wait,
but here's the thing. Hold on.
Dick. You guys y'all, keep saying y'all, dick
you,
is sex.
You wouldn't be willing to be a teacher and let that boy groom to the man that you want to be that you want. You don't believe in teaching.
I can teach you what I like.
That's what I'm saying. You could teach what you like.
I think I could.
Yeah, but if I find myself teaching him how to fuck, there's a different problem.
That's why? Maybe he's a virgin. That's fucked up.
Wait, do girls like virgins?
I feel like they low-key do because I feel like girls are controlling enough that they like to teach you what they like and what they want. Like, they become your personal teacher.
I don't
know.
I've never... I don't think I've ever thought about it like I'm attracted to you because you're a virgin.
Because there's some people out there like that.
I'm attracted to women because they're virgins.
I always ask. I'll be like, are you virgin?
Yeah, I think I ask for just to be curious. Yeah, but.
I always ask. I'll be like, are you, you know?
But I mean, nowadays, a lot of guys aren't virgin.
I'm a virgin.
All right.
Okay. Next question.
AJ Khan.
I can't be a virgin?
I know. What the fuck? Y'all just insulted me.
No, they're not talking about you. They're talking about me.
I know, but I said I was a virgin. We said it at the same time.
No, we're not on the same team.
All right. We are on the same
team. I got a question. Moving on. So you know when you go out to eat with your significant other and like shorty's not hungry, so the guy gets like the meal or whatever. Listen, you've dated before. You've gone on dates before.
Okay,
I'm sorry. And you ask shorty, you're like, yo, do you want to get something to eat? And she's like, nah. Especially like when you go to McDonald's. She's like, nah, I'm good. And then you get your food and she's like, can I have a fry? Do you guys mind sharing your food?
Do you get mad?
I think the first time I probably wouldn't get mad, but if it comes like a habit, I'm like, yo, I knew you were going to take my fries, bitch.
But that's when you catch on and be like,
I'm just going to order, yeah.
Yeah, but either way, you know? It's a lose-lose for us. That's what you guys don't understand. If we order you something, you're like, I don't want it. I told you I didn't want it.
We'd be confused.
I would never say no to food.
I'm not going to lie. I'd be confused sometimes because a man could be like, oh, to be honest,
I'll keep it a stack.
I don't know.
But then when you smell it, it's like, oh, I want that.
I'm going to be this way even if I'm a billionaire. It's going to be cheaper to share with you to get you your own meal. I don't give a fuck. You want some of these fries? Fuck it. Take them. I don't give a fuck. It's going to be cheaper to fucking let you pick at my food than get you and me a meal and you and me a drink. And so fuck it. I don't give a fuck. Whatever.
They might eat you up for that comment.
But you know what? I'm going to eat you up later on that day. Off the bone. So it's cool.
All right.
I'm going to get this man a water.
Now, so once you guys fall out of love, do you guys think it's possible to fall back into love with that same person?
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I think, yeah.
Yes.
I don't think the love ever falls off. I
believe in right person, wrong timing, and I feel like...
I don't believe in that shit.
No, I feel like... I'm going to give you an example. If you met me when I was 13, when you met me when I was 15, when you met me when I was 18, when you met me when I was 21.
All right, if they met you once.
No, what I'm saying, but I'm saying there's different stages of life. There's different stages of where you're at. So it's like, you know, I could have grew. No, I'm just saying I could have grew from the last time we dated and talked. Like, I feel like every person has a soulmate and you just meet at sometimes the wrong time in life.
I still don't agree, but okay.
Why don't you agree?
Because once I don't love you no more, it's a wrap. Okay. I may have love for you, I may respect you, cool. But I could never look.
All right, at you so the same. we met at 13, you know, boo loving on some dumb 13-year-old shit, and then we meet again at 23. Now we're talking what, 10 years later? 23, I'm a grown ass man. I got my own shit. I'm handling business.
Okay, but what if
I'm willing to wine and dine you, and I'm willing to like step up and be the man that you was asking for when I was 13.
You're talking about.
You gotta remember, y'all, thing about it is,
you didn't know how to wipe our ass.
But what I'm telling you,
it matters why you broke off.
But a girl at 13 and a man at 13 is different. We all know that a girl at 21 and a man at 21 is different. Y'all, it's scientifically proven. Y'all mature faster than men. Do so maybe it took that man time to realize like, yo, that girl was the
one. 21 he got 13-year-old brains.
But what if you had years with that person?
Now I think it depends why you fell out of love, because I think you can work at it and fall back into love 100%.
Let me tell you,
but if I fell out of love because you cheated,
oh, that's completely different. Let me tell you from experience. Hold on.
After DJ says this, I got a question.
From experience, when you're in love and you, let me not use the word waste, and you spend a year, 2 years, 6 months, 21 months, 24 months, 50 years. How many numbers did AJ say a few minutes ago?
He said a lot.
Just kept going, right? Anyways.
He said I could be AJ.
You're in love, so you don't know the time that's passing by. So when it comes to round two, when it comes to round three, you realize that you're wasting time. Before you were spending time with someone you love, now you're wasting time. And you don't want to waste the time the second time. You don't want to waste time the third time. You're like, yo, what the fuck am I doing? And when she's hitting you up after the fifth, sixth time she's blocked you or he blocked you, and you're like, yo, at this point, like, what do you want? I'm going to answer your question. Go home. Like, don't text me back again. You know what I'm saying? So there's this second chance, third chance, fifth chance, sixth chance, whatever situation anybody's in is fucking dumb.
It's a waste of time.
Yeah. But in the beginning, when it comes to love, it's not a waste of time. You're spending time with somebody you love. But when sometimes, the love isn't there, it's a waste.
Sometimes you need to, I feel like, I'm not going to speak on the ladies, but I'm going to speak for men. Sometimes you need to be, I guess, threatened to kind of realize what you have. Like, for example, if like, I really, like, let's say Soli's your down.
Yeah, but I feel like that's coming
let's
from a negative relationship.
Let's say Soli's your down ass shorty, but you're not mature enough to like realize that, right? And you're doing you, whatever, boom. Sometimes it takes to almost lose her to realize, oh shit, this was my down ass shorty. I need this girl in my life, like, to change that man. You feel what I'm saying?
So there's levels. So what you said, let me ask you a question. Do you guys think not cheating is the minimum in a relationship?
What do you mean the minimum?
The minimum. Like, there's women out there that are like, yo, my man don't cheat on me, I'm so happy. But
I think it's one thing. Yeah.
There's a million other things men can do and provide.
I mean, but if you say the minimum, I think it's bottom there. You know, it's at the bottom.
At least for respect and loyalty.
I feel like it depends on what age you are. Like,
it depends where you're coming from.
When you're teenagers and you're early.
No, not age different. I'm saying it depends where you're coming from.
18s, 19s, 20s, I'm not going to say it's acceptable.
Are you talking like culture-wise?
If you're from the streets and every man you've met, the last 100 relationships you've been in, treat you like shit, and they all cheated on you, and then that one person that doesn't cheat on you, you're like, oh my God, this is the love of my life because he doesn't cheat. That's not what a man is. You know what I'm saying? So some people get it twisted. So
he was just about to explain that. Only respect and loyalty. I don't think that makes a man. Like, there's other things that make a man.
Exactly.
Like, it contributes to it.
Right.
100%. But there's some women that are like, oh, he don't cheat on me, he's so nice, that's it.
But you know, it's crazy.
But there's some people like, we know that he's not going to cheat on me, so I'm not expecting him to cheat on me.
So I seen a post. I seen a post this week, and a shorty was like on Facebook. She's like, yeah, I'm never going to marry because all men cheat.
Exactly. That's their mindset.
All right, I got a question.
And they've been through it.
I got a question.
Everyone's been through different relationships.
I got a question for the ladies.
And I'm going to tell you something.
Hold on.
Let her talk.
Listen to the fucking podcast, bro.
When men cheat, I feel like they're not grown. They're still immature. They don't love themselves. Because if you love yourself as a man, you're not going to cheat. You're going to know what you have in front of you. And that's on period.
How about
same as a woman? Mm-hmm. You're not gonna cheat on a man.
Okay, but how about if what's in front of you?
There's a difference, and this is why it's not. I'm not gonna say it's not a big deal.
Hold on, self love is very important, even for men, because if you don't love yourself as a man,
you can't love no one else. Amen. You're
right. And I agree with you, but I'm gonna tell you the difference between men and females, right? So, men don't have to have emotional connection to you. Men don't have to really even like you to fuck you.
No.
Men don't even have to
fight. But you, if you know it's gonna hurt me, you better not do it.
No, hold on. Just hear me out. Men don't even have to find you attractive to fuck you, right? Men could fuck and go home and lay up.
Yeah, it's just busting a nut.
Yeah.
With their shorty, right? There's no emotional attachment to it. When females do it, there's some type of emotional attachment to it.
Like, so it's worse when a female cheats.
Oh, absolutely. Way more, way more, way more. Y'all fuck with emotions. There's a whole science behind why it's worse for a female rather than a male. I'm not saying it makes it better.
I'm gonna take a deep fuck this shit.
Hold on, I have a real question for the female.
Can we change the sex topic so we can have real clips and real conversation?
This is the real question. Real quick.
If it's about sex, I'm cutting you off.
Okay, fuck you. What do y'all feel about role playing?
Yep, next round, bro. Don't answer that, please.
No, what do y'all feel about role playing?
Shut up. What do you have for though?
What do y'all feel about role playing?
What you got? All right, so I got the next question.
What do you mean?
I don't want that answer.
You don't want to present the
question. What do y'all feel about role playing?
No.
Honestly, if my man, my boyfriend, my husband, whatever, if he wants me in a nurse lingerie, I'm going to wear one. But I ain't gonna be like, I don't know, there's some cringy ass shit. It's not happening. I ain't dressing up in a costume and like making voices at you. It ain't happening.
Why not?
Hell no.
What if that's what he wants?
It ain't happening.
What if he's like, baby, I want you to be the school nurse?
I can do like, you know, like, when you're in love, something stupid. But that whole like,
nah, fuck that. I want you to take me to the hospital, bring me back home.
All right, you bug.
Ambulance me, bring me back to house.
Put some sirens in your car.
Oh shit, this shit's hard for no reason. What's going on here?
Hold on, I got a question. When how do I word this? Say your significant other had like an accident and they were like paralyzed or something. What's that real love that you think people would stay there?
Shit.
Would stay there and actually take care of them and still love them the same?
If you love that person, you stay there. That shouldn't change anything.
Yeah, but it says that you I feel like you capping hard.
But paralyzed from like head to toe?
We're talking about like
everybody. You said would you stay in the relationship?
This man's dick is never going to work
again.
I
can't. But there has to be an agreement in that relationship you have to take
up. Which you can or you can't?
Can't.
Why can't you?
I feel like that's a conversation. Hold up.
This man has loved you and taken care of you for many years. Never cheated on you. Did you good. Had a work accident. Paralyzed.
I would 100% try to take care of you the most that I can.
Yeah.
I can't say like it's going to be a forever thing. I don't know. I've never been in that situation. Right. It comes with a lot.
I got a follow-up question after that, but DJ.
But I would 100% try to be that. You've been loyal to me. We got a family. We got a like a home together. That accident wasn't your fault. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try my hardest and give you everything I have.
But I'm saying in a relationship like you have to have that conversation.
I love you. Like, I love that for you, bro. I love that for you.
Love but that I for expect who? The oh, same wait, if, oh, if it was me.
I love that for you, man.
What are you talking about?
I love that for you.
Hold on, DJ got to say something.
In a relationship, I feel like you have to have that conversation. Like if something ever happens and you're paralyzed and you can't move and you can't fuck or suck or whatever it may be, you have to be like, hey, you know, if this situation happens, like, you know, we can still take care of each other, but you need to know that I need to still be pleasured and be happy maybe move on.
There's ways.
I don't think it's the same, though.
It's not. No one's going to agree to that. I'm just saying you should have that combo if you're in love.
I promise I am moving on in a month.
My jaw.
If I'm married, I'm having that conversation.
I could be paralyzed, but my jaw going to work. I'm just telling you that.
Just your jaw?
My jaw going to work.
Your tongue better work.
That's what I'm saying. My jaw and my tongue gonna work.
That's what I'm saying. There's other ways.
That shit gonna work.
I can settle. What's your follow up then?
I gotta break my
Oh my gosh.
I just took a bottle of tequila. What you mad? Oh my god.
That pinga dulce is pinga trash. Oh. Always gotta be.
Yo, she used your own line against you, bro.
go, your water broke.
All right, pause this shit.
No, we're not pausing. We're gonna keep going.
Keep going. It's been like 30 minutes.
No, y'all keep going.
We'll fuck you up.
All right, we're back. Yeah, there's tension here. I'm glad it's not me this time.
This ain't the all in all, bro. You're not walking off the fucking pod and we're gonna keep recording,
all right? Hey, don't. You're not disrespecting. You're not disrespecting the all in all like that either. But keep going.
You've been letting me do that.
All right, for and like we're back.
I would say the crazy shit.
All right, shh. We're back. Look at you. Yo, DJ. Yep. We're effing back, man.
I was gonna say I have elbow muscles now.
Go.
It don't matter. Yeah, we didn't care about the elbow.
Your forearms are looking skinny.
Elbows, bro.
All right.
You've been jerking off.
Did you have something?
You've been jerking off.
And we're back.
And we're back. Okay. Who's starting it off?
Destiny. Destiny's coming in hot.
I forgot. Wait. Give
me a
minute.
A little chilly, a little cold.
Give it. All right.
This man might have pissed in your kitchen, bro. Came back.
Wait.
That was way too fast.
I got a question. Have any of you guys ever been handcuffed? Oh, I said that weird.
Handcuffed.
Wait.
Hancock?
Handcuffed.
Will Smith.
Was that a little British? Handcuffed.
Sorry. Does it matter what way?
Hell no. Tell us all about it.
Does it matter what?
What way?
She said sexually or legally.
Oh, shit.
Both.
You got arrested, bitch? Yeah. I'm so sorry. My fault. Yeah, my fault. You got me hyped, bro. You got me hyped. My fault. I take that. She's talking sexually. You over here like, yo, I got arrested, handcuffs. My fault. I'll take it back. You got arrested, my love?
Yes. In
high
school.
Rewind. You got arrested, my love.
Wait, can we in know why?
What happened? Legally or sexually?
Did the police tackle you? They used to tackle every time there was a fight.
Nah. It was just a high school fight, and I got arrested.
Like you just got.
It was, you know, either we take you or we take you. You know, I got handcuffed.
No choice. We taking you.
And then I got handcuffed, you know, and the other way. So.
Oh, the other way too.
Yeah,
I started a riot in high school.
Which one you like better?
What? Wait, from what?
She said you got handcuffed both.
Like, oh, okay. Oh.
Which one you look better?
Nah, see, my thing is.
Did the officer manhandle you the right way or did your man?
I'm gonna keep it a buck.
Yo, you got some if you're not talking to the mic, I don't care.
All right, unless you got some real handcuffs, you're gonna break out of that shit. That shit is whack. You need to have some real handcuffs so they can't pull out of that shit.
So you had handcuffs and locked up in the cage?
Now he had handcuffs that didn't work in here.
Yeah, he got five below.
It didn't hold it.
I bought some pink furry handcuffs one time.
I had the same one, but if you're not talking to the mic, I don't care. I had the same pink handcuffs.
That shit was whack.
Yo, set up.
Talking to the mic, AJ.
AJ's gone.
I'm talking into the mic.
Yo, AJ.
I'm telling you right now, that shit is whack when you get them pink furry shits.
It's okay.
Get the real deal.
Get the real deal. The shit that you need the key for so you don't break out of that podcast, shit. Fam.
Would you have like a, what do you call that? You know, like a word?
A safety word?
Yeah.
Watermelons.
I didn't ask what
you said the first time.
I'm asking if you have one.
No, we said pineapples.
Oh, pineapples? Oh, when he was screaming that last time?
Pineapples!
Yeah.
Nah, AJ's safety word would be, damn, what was it? How do you say sour in Spanish?
Agrio.
Pinga agria.
It would be canepas. It would be canepas. It would be canepas. Stop it.
So, guys and girls, if your friend has like a strange, weird kink, does that change your relationship with them once you find out what it is?
Yeah. How early are they telling
me? I think so.
If it's mad weird.
Because if I...
Not like a stink, a kink.
No, something...
Because if I... asking what a kink is.
Oh, like, say AJ, he likes at home. Hold on.
Let's go outside right
now. Hold
on.
Can we...
I swear to God.
Yo, come on. Dennis having a convo.
Yeah, he's talking. And he's lit.
This is what I deal with you when you're lit. You have to deal with it.
And I scream into the mic.
So what does a kink mean?
You don't say nothing.
So like people, like a fetish kind of. Like you like something sexually. Some guys fetish? Like girls peeing on themselves.
What's your fetish?
I had someone tell me like, oh, their weird kink is they're attracted to guys with big noses. I'm like, all right.
Big nose?
Yeah.
Well, like what's your kink? What's your fetish? Like, yeah, I want this motherfucker to piss on me.
AJ likes being walked like a dog.
Well, so is something engages. That I like or something I don't
something,
like?
No, that you do like.
Woof!
That you, this man's like, gonna make these crazy assumptions. Or whatever.
That is not true.
Oh.
Never.
But it's not even about
I'll
you.
I'll walk you like a bitch.
You find out your best friend has a weird kink. I don't know, like the weirdest thing you, like, I don't know, she likes a guy to piss in her mouth.
Or shit in her mouth.
Or anything, like anything, like something weird. Is that changing your relationship with her or with him?
And this is your best friend.
That's it. Do you?
But how about if one day?
Like, I'm not gonna say. I'm gonna give you an example.
No, hold on.
I'm not gonna say. It's, I'm not gonna. Hold on, real quick. I'm not gonna say it's not. It's true or not.
But allegedly, Odell Beckham had told a girl, take a shit and don't wipe.
And
And sit take on his a chest. Shit and then, you know, sit on his face, sit on his chest, whatever.
So do you look at him differently?
Yeah, definitely. Because look, how about if one day we're chilling?
If a dude's like, yo, don't take a shit and don't wipe.
Yeah. Because
I want to eat you up.
Because how about if one day we're chilling? Like, say, let's say it's podcast day.
If you like that, then that's cool, but you're not going to like it with me.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? You
can, but either way, it affects you.
Because I'm very clean.
It affects you. Because say it's podcast day and say one of you guys like that and you come here smelling like shit. We ain't cool no more. I'd be like, yo, I can't sit here for an hour.
He's talking to you, and it's like,
oh, yeah, I'm like, yo, I can't sit here for an hour with you because you stink like doodle.
Stink like what? Doodle. I think so, like noodles. He said like I was trying to say some shit.
That's crazy.
DJ, what's your question? Usually,
got? I got a question. You're on AJ's side today.
What y'all feel about spitting in the mouth?
I was on your side when you were lit.
What y'all feel about spitting in the mouth?
Yeah, there you go, buddy.
I don't know.
What y'all feel about spitting in the mouth?
Yeah, I don't know.
You ain't spitting in mine.
I don't fuck with that.
You don't fuck with that?
I've had it.
Shorties.
I tried it.
You tried it? You liked it?
In the moment, yeah. But
in the moment?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, when you're in love, you could kind of try everything.
Yeah, I feel you.
I'm not even going to lie to you.
It's no knock. It's no knock. If you like it, you like it.
It's kind of like a freaky thing.
Man's is hitting every single spot, and he's like, grabs you by the back of the hair and spits in your mouth.
My mouth ain't open. I'm gonna close that shit.
So he spits on your face.
I'm gonna move my head. Oh, you missed. Like, it ain't happening.
So he spits on your face?
I have a weird thing. Like, I don't know, warm saliva in my mouth. It's different when you're kissing because it's not like
I just think water. I just think spitting is like disrespectful.
What if he's eating your pussy
and he spits on it?
And then no, not only he spits on your pussy, but after he's
this
eating
man,
it, he's
done, horny today.
He's eating you up and then he spits in your mouth.
Wait.
No, he's not spitting. You can kiss me. You're not spitting in my mouth.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wait. You want to spit somewhere? You can spit
hold
down
on,
there.
No, she said it depends how you spit.
What
do you mean by that? Like
if you do it disrespectfully, I bet you ain't shit. You know
yeah, that's all day.
Like, I'll punch you in your face.
Why is that the situation during
like
sex though?
Shit, like you know, you into it. And it's kind of
spitting.
Yeah. If it, I'm not saying I would never do it. If it happens and it's in the
during
moment,
during sex, 100%. Spitting could be considered bad.
When you're in love and you. I don't know. I just say when you're in love and you
no, you do anything. I agree. Yeah.
When you're in love, you don't spit. When you just fucking, you spit on bitches.
It's like I'm gonna be honest with you. If a girl fucks a guy, and they're not in a relationship, I don't feel like. So I had somebody, I'm not gonna mention any names, ask me, do you think that, if you suck a nigga's, should I suck every nigga's dick? And I was like, no.
She asked you that?
Yeah. And I was like, I don't think every guy that if you're going to fuck around, you just do you. But don't be like.
On every guy.
Put it in your mouth. Like, you know, because.
Put it in your ear.
Yeah.
All right. So my question, right. I have a question right here. And it is. Craziest thing a guy. This could start to the. We're going to start to the left. To Soli. Craziest thing a guy or a girl has asked you to do?
Craziest thing? Damn, I don't know.
Deli's like, damn, don't blow up my spot. Don't do it. Don't blow up my spot.
I'm thinking. Like,
craziest thing a girl or a guy has asked you to do?
Like, I'll tell you what, my teacher telling me to read out in front of the class. I said, yo, you better chill.
What?
I said, you better chill.
Where the fuck did that come from?
Yo. He said the craziest thing. I remember, she's like, Fidel, you're next. And I said, I used to study the paragraphs. I used to be like, I got this one. And if I didn't have it, I was like, yo, fuck.
No, but I think like the craziest thing I ever did was like snuck out my house. Because Fidel asked me to. And I put a mannequin. I had a fake hand. I had a phone that didn't work.
You ruined this church, girl.
No. So I put the phone on the charger, put the fake hand, blankets, pillows, everything. It looked like a body. I was out with him. See, but you see, I don't, like, at that age, it was crazy.
Yeah.
At that age, it was crazy. But everything I've done is, like, with him, everything.
Damn.
So I think that's, like, the craziest thing. But I was dumb young.
Bad influence.
That's that new middle school love.
100%.
That high school.
That's that pinga
middle
dulce.
DJ's been quiet. He's angry at you.
Yes.
He's mad at you. Don't
fuck that bald-headed Dominican.
I'm chilling.
Talk your shit.
I'm part of your conversation.
Talk your shit. I know you got shit. Fuck my question. Go ahead. Air your shit
I'm part of all the sexual conversations we're going to have. Just make sure I'm going to clip everything.
I don't give a fuck.
DJ.
And that's clipped.
What do you think about AJ's braids? You ever wanted braids?
He can't.
I told you, we're going to do the Drake special. Beard. I'm going to have the fucking...
He can only braid his beard.
The section cut. You don't have a beard, so I don't know why you would even mention the beard.
Yeah, because I don't eat ass like you.
This is tension.
You don't eat the ass like me?
Yeah. Get the glove.
That's a compliment, though. That's a compliment.
Next question.
I'll take that one, no.
Didn't you say... Yeah, take it. Like, next question.
No one else has craziest shit they've ever done?
No, this is... This is this
I
don't think I have
anything
crazy. That's what I'm saying. I love to experience anything. I haven't experienced anything.
Shit? No.
So when you guys hear that on the crazy podcast, you think I'm crazy. I'm not. I just haven't experienced anything.
Nothing. She's capping.
What?
This bitch is Latina. What the fuck? You go believe her, bro?
I didn't hear what you said.
She doing drive-bys and all that bullshit. You gonna believe?
I used to do drive-bys. Now I don't waste my time.
Explain drive-bys. Because this sounds crazy. Because
Shorty done did whole ultrasounds with weed in them and shit. Like, come on.
Yo.
Yeah, AJ's bugging.
But
she done did some crazy shit.
DJ, we're giving you a chance. Next question, buddy.
I'm ready for the regular combos. You guys are ready. I'm stop talking
if
about
I'm
sex.
If I'm telling you next question, bring it on.
Yeah, but my man wants to talk about sex all now. Let's talk about
sex. Bring it up. Bring it up.
All right, you guys ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah, shoot.
Do you guys know what women want in this world?
If the woman knows what she wants.
No. I said, you guys.
Oh, guys.
Do the guys know the number one thing in the world that women want?
Do you?
They want to feel like a queen.
They want security.
And that's feeling like a queen.
So I'm happy that we have our monthly chatter that, you know, some people wanted to cancel that on my right side. But women want to be included. Does that make sense?
Not the only thing.
Yeah.
Like, I want security, stability, respect, loyalty.
Women want to be included.
So I have a question.
You don't get that when you first meet somebody. There's no security. There's no love. You're not talking to the mic. There's no love. There's no security. There's no money.
Do you, when you feel meet some somebody, type of way when there's attractive females on your man's podcast?
No.
You don't?
No.
But I feel like that's because we laid it down from the start.
Yeah,
we talked about it and I said,
why would I feel some type of way if you're... This is my thing. Like, woman overthink.
Shorty's like, yeah, I love that nigga. Like, this nigga.
Nah, my thing is, like, woman overthink. If I see a female or I hear, like, clips and the female's, like, constantly throwing herself at Fidel, I'll be like, yo, who the fuck is this bitch?
Right.
I'm a question it, but I'm not gonna be like, you can't have no more shorties on, no. I'm like, yo, I respect that. I find this like a business. I don't
you
see
just,
it as...
You just got
to
check.
Yeah, it's her. Not competition to me. I know what I bring to the
she
table.
She needs to know that's yeah. And you're doing a podcast.
Queen Soli, snap your fingers.
Yeah, you got to check her politely. Be like, yo, I kind of thought that was uncalled for. That's my
yeah, and
name.
I'm going to come to Fidel. I'm going to be like, babe, that's disrespectful.
Yeah, no, not only that, you're on a podcast with other guys and another female. You should have more respect for yourself.
Yeah.
Respect for me and respect for my man in my house because, come on. I mean,
that's another. You're coming to my crib,
right?
Sis, this
what
is
if
my
one,
crib.
One person on the podcast is single, and we want the compliments.
Yeah, she can throw it all at you. You want to?
No, she said the lovely gentlemen in this room are very, very well spoken and very sexy. You know, but you know, I'm single, and I'm like, thank you so much.
Yeah, but we're
last
we're
podcast.
Different though.
So last podcast, but she was like, "Oh, who on this podcast would you date based off of what they said? Like that, something like that wouldn't bother you."
Now I asked Fidel. I didn't even hear the clip. I said, yo, what the hell did Shorty say? And then he told me, he's like, oh, Shorty's like, you know, which one of these guys would you date based on what they said? I'm like, oh, okay. But I don't.
But I feel like if you're a secure woman, you wouldn't be so, like, edged on
And if you trust your man, too.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You got that.
Yo, but I know my value if you're not going to value me.
But if you've gone through so much trauma, can you really, truly trust your man?
Wait.
It depends if you're going to trauma with him.
Exactly. The trauma you've been through, for example, can you really, truly trust your man? I don't think you can.
Okay, so
you've been through some crazy trauma.
Wait a minute. Hold on. You're going to... Callate. If it's a new guy, then yes, I'm going to give you the benefit of the doubt so I can trust you. You got to gain that trust. You're not the old guy. I can't compare you guys.
I respect
him. Okay, so I might have trauma with my ex, but let's say I'm dating... No disrespect, you know, DJ, he's not going to sit here and act, you know, and if he, I'm not going to compare him to, you know, my ex. He has nothing to do with it. All
right, cool.
Now, yeah. My thing is, that's a good question because I
what
feel...
What did I do?
No.
She was giving you because you, yeah. you know...
I feel like shorties overthink too much.
You're the big daddy yum-yum.
Oh, okay.
Now, so I feel like shorties overthink too much. I even seen this clip on TikTok and it was like... I have it right here, the question. So do you guys think that the issue with women is that they overthink cheating too much? Absolutely. So it's like their guy went out, and all of a sudden she's like, he's cheating on me. Why? Because he's not answering the phone.
If, I have to say, if you have so much trauma and you haven't healed for yourself, then yes. But if you're already healed, then that's a different story.
You shouldn't be questioning
yourself. But if I met you and from the beginning you tell me don't go out, then I should move on.
Yeah, if you want to go out, be with a different person.
Exactly. Yeah. Absolutely. If you tell me that from the beginning, though, I not say, 8 months later,
everybody's entitled to do, you know, what they want, how they feel. Nothing's wrong. You know what I'm saying?
No, like, number one advice, if you don't like something, if something's a red flag, address that shit. Address it. I'm don't wait. This. 6 months later when, I don't know, your guy went out for the 20th time, now it bothers you.
But it's different.
No, address it the first time it happens.
But if it happens again, that's when you know you got to cut it.
Right.
But let me put it this way. If you
let it happen again, then that's your fault.
Exactly. If you meet a guy at the club and then you tell him to stop clubbing, you're an idiot. But if you meet someone at the gym, if you meet someone at the supermarket and then you realize they're an alcoholic or you realize they go out every single weekend and then you're like, hey, you know, I met you at the supermarket. I didn't know anything about you. Now we're like 3 months in and I'm seeing that you're going out every single weekend. I don't go out. So I need to let you know now that, like, if this is what you do the rest of your life, like, this is not what we're going to do for the rest of our life.
Yeah, you're addressing
it.
Yeah,
you're addressing it.
But
and she has a choice.
In the situation that you met that person. But if you met that person at the club, you can't say, hey, don't go out next weekend. It's us now.
I mean, you can say it, but you can't expect him not to go.
Either. You can't change a man's life.
Or she has an option. He or she has an option to either respect it or bounce.
Mm-hmm. And it's early, so you should know.
Yeah.
And then 99% of the time, trust your gut feeling.
But I'm going to say, wait, someone posted on Facebook, I waited 3 years. This guy never took me out. This guy played me. This guy, this and that. And the first sentence
your
was...
Fault. That's your fault.
The
you
first sentence was
time.
I wasted 3 years.
I said
3 years. After 3 to 6 months, it's over, bro. Like,
bro, if you
had
taken me on a date before I met you, we ain't going to be in a relationship.
Did you see that viral video? It was like, I was dating this guy for 6 years.
You know
and I was dressing up saying, take me out. I was dressing up saying, take me out. I was getting pretty. I was doing makeup.
She shouldn't tell you to take out.
And after 6 years, I broke up with him because he didn't want to take me out because all he wanted to do was work. Now, there are men out there that want to work and they're homebodies, which 100% she fucked up on because she found the homebody. But 6 years later, you haven't been taken out on a date.
Yeah, that's not.
Why'd you wait 6 years? That doesn't make any sense. Mm-hmm.
She said next year it'll be better. I'll try again.
So here's my question.
Wasting time. You're wasting time.
To switch the convo. Is Drake, Drake's abs real?
Drake?
Are they real? How would I know? What? I've never seen it. I don't
know.
That
was weird.
No, a lot of people say that he got the surgery.
The BBL? The news guys, you know.
The bad man kept old BBL?
I don't know.
Have you seen people, like, contour their abs to make them look bigger?
Yeah.
Oscar De La
Hoya. All right, so my here's my real question. Yeah. Dad bod or abs?
Dad bod all day.
My nigga's a dad.
Unless
bod.
You Michael B. Jordan, then I'm going to holler at you like, yo.
Your N-word's up there.
You know what I'm saying?
What you saying, dad bod all day?
Yeah. In real life? Real life? Yeah, dad bod.
Dad bod.
But if I get lucky with the guy that's, you know, then hey, you know, I get lucky.
Can I ask a serious question? This is going to switch everything up because we talk about men crying in front of women and women not wanting men that cry in front of them. But for the men, have you guys ever had an experience where a woman cried in front of you and you're like, damn, I really don't want her anymore because she's too emotional. She does this and that.
Nah.
Yeah.
You said yeah?
Talk a little closer to the mic about that, please.
Elaborate. Go ahead.
Elaborate on the next to the mic.
You're gonna throw up?
No. 1 foot closer. Suck the mic real quick, please.
So you're saying, like,
you seen a girl cry and you're like, damn, this girl's mad emotional. This might not be the one.
But
for
like
me.
You're shorty or a girl you're talking to?
It doesn't matter.
I'm talking about my shorty. Yeah. Nah, definitely. Most definitely. Most definitely. Like, if we been dating, whatever, and you really like bug out on some shit. I might be like, yeah, this might not be the girl for me.
Do you have an example? I have an example.
My example is, so like one time I was working at Sky Zone. I was going to Johnson Wells University and I was working at Sky Zone in Providence. And I had like a bunch of my coworkers over or whatever. And like, shorty bugged out in front of everybody. Out of nowhere. Like, out of nowhere. And that's like, for me, it was like.
She bugged out. Why? Because you had people.
I don't know why.
I don't like that. Nah.
To this day, I don't know why. Like, shorty used to bug. It would be random shit. Like.
That's why.
All right. Like, so, like, I dated an ex that was like. She wasn't a drinker, so she didn't want me to drink. Like, on my 21st birthday, she was mad that I was drunk.
That's unfortunate.
I mean, that's a red flag. Why should.
Yeah,
I would have
left her.
I'm saying,
how long you dating for?
I mean, you know who she is. But anyway,
I asked for a date. I didn't know name. How long did you
date
her for?
I didn't say name.
No, yeah. How long did you date her for?
On and off, like a year and a half.
1 year too long.
A year and a half, 2 years.
That's tough because when you're young,
it wasn't like that. But like I said, when I turned 21, it was like, Shorty's mad that I'm drinking. Shorty mad, like at the time, like
when it's crazy because your college, 21st birthday wasn't an exception.
Yeah,
I think that's an exception. Drink.
But hold on, I'm gonna keep it a buck. In college, I didn't even really like to drink like that. I liked to smoke when I was in college.
She was younger, right?
Shorty, yeah, Shorty didn't even fuck with that either.
So my example is, I let a shorty drive for the first time. We were like a year in.
Yeah, that's when you fucked up.
Yeah. Girls driving. Woo!
I said it for the first time.
There was a truck that swerved kind of to the left of the third lane. And she had anxiety, so I didn't want to like point it out. But like, she deadass had a panic attack during the time where she was supposed to be driving and almost killed us on the highway. I don't think so anymore.
Oh, never mind.
So she had a panic attack while she was driving. I'm in the driver's seat, and she was fucking swerving and crying and shaking. And I'm like, bitch, pull the fuck over before you kill us.
Right. Let me drive. Don't touch my car ever again.
It turned me completely off.
Yeah,
I hear you, but you can't also call her a bitch off of that.
I didn't call her a bitch.
You just said.
No, I just said, bitch, turn over. He's just talking like
hypothetical.
I'm saying, yeah. Yo, turn the fucking car over. You know what I'm saying?
Like, I mean, look at it. You gave her the opportunity. You learn from that.
Yeah.
And it's like, you never touch my car.
Never, ever driving again.
But my thing is like, if not you have
not even about
road
the car.
Fear, don't touch my car.
It's not even about
be
the car.
Honest.
It's about my life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I love my
I got
life
a friend.
Much.
I got a friend that was like, he was like with a girl who was like, spazzing out. She was on some like, I'm going to kill us both. But she only crashed.
I would have snuffed her.
She only crashed. She only crashed his side of the car. So he got fucked up. He broke his hip.
And she was good.
He bit through his tongue.
Broke his tongue.
He broke his hip. Like, he got all fucked up. And, like, he still stayed where?
That's crazy.
Stayed?
That's crazy. I would have cut her off.
So they just dated together?
No, hell no. Not
I mean, some
day.
Guys like
but
crazy.
But after that, like, I'm going to give I know somebody else, too, like.
You know a lot of people.
I do. Yeah, I know a lot of people.
Shout out to you.
I know somebody else that, like. Oh, we haven't even been together for a year. Shorty broke up with me 2 different times. So I'm giving him advice like, I don't really think this is the one for you. Like, you know,
yeah,
Shorty's a good girl. Shorty's a good girl. Like, but I really don't think she's the one for you. Like, you don't get all caught up. Boom, boom, boom. You don't make the breakup harder if you keep going along with it every time she want to get back together. Blah, blah, blah. Nigga don't listen to me. And fucking now they back together.
Mind I think you, it's tough to listen.
Mind
to
you, he was just.
You're gonna do what you want.
Exactly.
Mind you, he
until
was just venting to me
hard.
Like.
You're never gonna
he was just venting to me like
and
a few
I
days ago.
Experience.
He was like, "Yeah, I'm done for sure this time." I'm like, "Okay, cool, mm-hmm. cool."
I
boom,
said
boom.
That a lot.
Two days later, back with
yeah,
that.
Shorty hit him up at 3 a.m. Yeah. Can I come by?
It's not until you get that hit and you be like, "All right, now it's good."
Oh, that has to be a bad hit.
This one's for everybody. Listen. This one's for everybody. Does size matter?
No.
In a relationship, when it comes to weight,
you gotta be able to go up and downstairs. You gotta be able to fit in my
car. You gotta be able to.
Damn. How big have you gone, sis? How happy have you made a man?
He's with Captain Central America. What
you mean? That's my thing. If you can't play with our kid, that's not. I don't think that's cool.
Yeah.
That's. It's
but
not
what
even,
if you're the one feeding him?
That's my thing. I'm gonna be healthier about it. If it's my fault that you're fat, babe, we're going on meal preps. We're going on this. We're going to the gym. Like,
yo, you forced that. I can't imagine somebody not getting into a car.
Yeah. Oh, you're talking about 400 pounds.
That's OD.
You're talking about the girl on the plane that has to get two seats.
Or be able to satisfy her. Like, that's a different kind of big.
Motherfucker.
You can't. Not my other thing. You can't stink. Like. Oh, okay. That's yeah. one thing. You go to the
you know
bathroom?
In jail they say that.
I know. Yo, you go come to the in bathroom?
Fat, they're like, yo, do 100 pushes right now, you fat fuck, and they'll tell you that off rip.
I'm not saying I don't like guys with me because I do, mm-hmm. but like. I don't know, just not crazy.
My thing about it is like
I feel like if you're having like trouble breathing low, going up the yeah. stairs or even waking up, then there's a problem.
If you can't get boys, off the bed, if low, you can't wait, wait, be on top,
you have a trouble waking up.
If
how does that work?
If by the time you get up from the bed and you're
niggas, I can't wake up.
You know, you need your bump.
Little boys like what? Little boys like bones and grown ass men like meat.
Little boys
wait,
like
that,
bones.
That sounds gay.
Wait, what? Yeah, what did you say?
Little boys like bones and grown ass men like me.
All right, so I'm skinny. What are you trying to say?
Oh, okay.
Oh, towards girls, females. For girls, for yeah, girls. I'm like,
bro. He's saying you attract little boys.
Oh, I was about to say.
Is that what he said?
Are you,
I'm
though?
I'm trying to.
Oh, yeah.
You
yeah.
said you're skinny, but are you, though?
I think I'm skinny.
You think she's fat?
Yeah, I never said that.
She's not. But, she can fit in the car.
But are you thinking of? Are you? But hold on. When a nigga's hitting it from the back, does it sound like he's smacking a pack of Newport cigarettes?
Clip it. So
shit deep. Claps.
Did he say Newport cigarettes?
No. Shit claps.
Cigarettes?
Shit claps. His pelvic bone gonna hurt?
No.
All right. So you good?
Hi, agent.
That's Fidel's best friend right there.
DJ's doing the clip.
I'm Fidel's best friend now.
Yeah, we're not friends anymore.
Wait,
bro.
So let's change it up a little bit.
Fight you right
you
now.
You got one?
Yeah, yeah.
I was gonna say something ago.
What do you guys think is the biggest mistake parents make when raising their children?
Oh, that's
a wise man once told
me. That's easy.
If you give your kids junk food and soda and all that bullshit, and you make them fat. You'll be fat your whole life.
Nah, who was that wise man?
You.
The man with his nipples out.
Hold on. Let me.
I went on my Dominican John back today.
All right, shut up. Because that's not the question.
I feel like the biggest mistake parents make when raising a kid is forgetting how they grew up, their childhood,
right. Yes.
Forgetting what they wanted when they were kids.
Forgetting that they were kids.
Yeah, period. Forgetting that they were kids.
I'm going to be honest with you. I struggle with my kids, and my son is going to be in second grade, and I'm still, like, I had this conversation with somebody. He's a boy. You know, he's hitting second grade, and his mouth is crazy. So there's things where I grew up. I didn't grow up healthy with both parents. So with me, the way I grew up, I kind of find myself doing things where who raised me, I'm doing it to my kids. So sometimes I have to snap out of it and be like, yo, whoa.
I didn't like that one.
Especially shit you didn't like yeah. growing
exactly.
up, yeah.
To me, it, as a kid, it made me feel like, damn, you know what I mean? And I find myself sometimes like, you know, giving that same energy to my kids. Sometimes, I'm not just trying to say that.
No, but it's hard. Being a parent,
it's hard. And that's why I feel like there was a time where you guys talked about, oh, that grandparents, they love their grandchildren more than their kids. That's true because I feel like, you know, as a parent, me speaking for myself, in the future, which my kids better not make me a grandma anytime soon. They better at least have that diploma. But what I'm saying is, when as a parent, you're still learning how to parent. And if you didn't have the mother or the father or any type of, you know, person to teach you how to be a mom or to guide you, whatever, it's harder. So for grandparents, they already did their mistakes. They already learned their mistakes.
You learned from
so
it, yeah.
So now for the grandkids, they're like, I know I did that with you, but I don't like that you do that to your son. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because they learn. So
yeah. I seen a video the other day that was like, take your shirt off in front of a whole crowd. And the man was uncomfortable. And he said, the next time someone tells you to take your shirt off, make sure you're comfortable in front of your kids to take your shirt off because that's how you want your kids to be in the future. And when I seen that video, my dad's been my size like my whole life. And I'm happy not being obese. I'm happy not being super skinny. I'm happy being a little, you know, a little chubby. Because my dad's always been a little chubby my whole life. But he showed me as a grown man, 40, 50, 60, that he could be chubby and happy. You know what I'm saying? So the video was telling him, go work out, go get a six pack, and tell your kids to have a six pack in the future. What do you guys think about that?
I think you should teach your kids to be healthy.
But how are you going to do that if you don't show them? You can't teach them.
You have to show 100%.
That's what I'm trying to say.
You have to be an example. You have to be an example for your kids. But I feel like sometimes it's hard for us to be an example. So why not school them, even though we make the mistake to school ourselves? Mm-hmm. And, like, you know.
My goal is to always make whatever kids I bring into this world better than I was.
Yeah, I think another thing is
whether that's healthier, more fit, more better looking, more athletic, more whatever, just better than me.
Yeah, I agree with that.
So if I'm your kid,
hold on, and going off of that, we need to break generational curses. I think whatever we don't break as a parent, our kids will bring it with them throughout their life. Whether it's like family drama, family issues, whatever it is, like mental illness, you need to break it for yourself and provide like a home that's like, I don't know, more like stable mentally, like physically, everything.
Emotionally, everything
for your child.
I respect what you had to say. Why couldn't you just tell me, give me a minute? Like, give me a minute. Hold on. Made it sound like I cut you off 100 times today already.
AJ, then you did.
Okay.
Go.
I was going to say, if I'm 16, 17, and my dad's drunk on a Monday night, then I believe I can be drunk on a Monday night.
Because it's that's normal.
Yeah. That's what you see. Yeah,
you know?
But I feel like as you grow up, you realize certain stuff isn't really... To you, it's normal because you grew up doing it, experiencing it, and everything. But you realize, my friend's parents aren't like that. Right. Or my girlfriend's parents
aren't like that. That's where you have...
You have to break that curse.
Exactly. That's where you come in and you make a choice whether you want to continue to be like your parents or you want to
break. I think it's tough, but yes.
I have it.
I feel like...
It's like the excuse of guys, but... Oh, well, I never had my father, so I'm going to sit there and be a piece of shit and not be a father to my
kids. You should be a better father.
Exactly.
A better father, yeah.
You should learn. You have the choice to continue to be like a piece of shit dad because you had that and it wasn't your fault.
My thing is, you know how it affected you. Exactly. Don't let it affect your kids
the same way. It wasn't your fault as a child because you didn't ask to be here. You didn't ask to have a parent like that. So for you have the choice to either I want to be like that, a piece of shit, or I'm not going to be like that because my kids deserve better.
So for the ladies... We had a conversation the other day where someone's like, yo, what do you think about the drug dealers and, you know, the gangbangers that women date and this and that? And I said, because I grew up from a different side of the city, I was like, why do we have to talk about drug dealers and gangbangers? And a woman stopped me and said, why can't we talk about drug dealers and gangbangers? Because that's where we're from. Our culture is from that. That's a mindset that people are putting in their head that all Spanish people have to be drug dealers and gangbangers to make it out of the hood.
Because they're so used to seeing that.
I think that's an easy way out.
Yeah, that's
like an excuse. You have a lot to lose.
Some people use that as an excuse. Like, oh, because of that, I'm not going to, you know.
But, like, I was trying to save the convo. I was like, why are you guys mentioning drug dealers and gangbangers with these women when we could talk about someone that has $1 million or someone that has...
There's drug dealers that have $1 million.
Right.
And they get arrested after 10 years.
Not everyone.
I feel like the downfall is, bro, they get too greedy.
Yeah. Chapo got locked up, bro. That's it.
Too greedy, yeah. He could have been chilling.
It is greedy.
I love having that combo.
It's always about greed, bro.
And that's what everything, bro. Like,
I'm going to change the topic, though.
It's avarice and greed.
No, keep going.
You want to talk about the Chapo? And your peoples?
No, I was talking about greedy.
And your peoples?
What about my people?
You calling him a drug dealer?
Whoa.
Yeah. You say you and your
people. That's racist.
No, you.
You say all his people are drug dealers?
I'm supposed to be inspired motor. They're going to be like, yo, they're going to unfollow me.
Clipping.
Listen. He ain't one.
Am I the asshole?
Yes.
Or stop going to church because I got in a car accident and I almost died.
No, I think this is where people get mixed up.
Wait, time out.
Go ahead. Sorry,
you said you stopped going to church because you got in a car accident and you almost died?
This is my thing. You are blaming the car accident.
But you alive.
But this is the thing. Like, you should be grateful. I'm not saying you should go to church. Be grateful that you're alive. Mm-hmm. Thank God that you're alive. Thank God that it was only your car that had damage. You look fine to me. You're walking. You could have been hit. I don't know. Like, some damage could have been done to your body. But don't use the you stopped going to church because you got into a car accident. That event might have impacted it. But you still have the choice to go to church every week. Or I don't know how often they do service.
So... I feel like church, it has nothing to do with...
It's not going to save you. Yeah, no, it has nothing to do with us.
So if you stop going to church, you have your reasons to go to church. It's not go to church. But the church is not God.
Exactly. So I agree.
If you're mad or whatever the case is, if you feel like, oh, God, you allow this. God allows things for us to, you know, learn and shit like that. But it's not God's fault.
And don't go to church thinking you're going to be saved because that's not how it works.
Exactly. Church is different from God.
Damn, this has been a long. Should we go to lessons of blessings?
Nah, we're going. I got questions. No, I'm back. I got a quick question.
I got a quick question.
I got a list. Where's I,
so
bro?
So if your kid is getting jumped, are y'all really jumping in and kicking other people's children out?
No, you know what? I have something to say. So last year in kindergarten, my son got picked on, and these were fourth graders. He's a kindergarten, and I went to the school. Basically said what I had to say. My son is a certain way, and I told him, I'm not coming back for a meeting. You guys got to nip this in the bud, and that's it. Because I'm like this, and I'm like that. And I don't want to be like that. I don't want to have to come out of character as a mother.
Right,
you know what I'm saying? But it upsets me because it's like not too long ago, my son was in a jumpy house, and some kid was jumping on his back. And
you fucked that kid
I
up.
Seen him, and the ladies that were, you know, manejando, I don't know how you say that in English, you know, guiding the who goes in and who comes out. It was that kid's been doing it, blah blah blah. So he tried to lie. He didn't see that I was watching him. So he tried to be like, oh, but your son, no, you didn't, because you was trying to jump on my son. And I told my son, I said, I let it slide. But if somebody hits you, you hit him back.
You hit him back, 100%.
Oh, and then
yes, you can. Absolutely. Defend yourself. I don't care. You defend yourself.
Yes.
Someone pushes you, you punch them.
Hold on, Soli. It's true.
Hold on, sis.
If somebody's trying to, listen, I just don't play that as a single mom. And I know how my son is. He's a walking heart. He doesn't understand the concept of somebody being mean and trying to be funny or being nice. He thinks everybody's his friend. So, but mommy knows otherwise. You know what I'm saying? So if I see that, I told him, I said, the next time he hits you, you hit him back.
Yeah.
And then he can go get his mom or his dad, and I'll explain. I'll talk nicely, but if the mom or dad wants to get rowdy, we could go to that level. I'll try to avoid that level as much as I can. But I'm not going to let your son try
bully
to
your
punk
son.
My son.
Yeah, no.
Absolutely
no
not.
Matter what age?
No matter, no.
It doesn't matter
fuck
age.
These kindergartners, you heard?
It doesn't matter.
For my
age.
Kid,
and that
I would
goes
do
for
anything.
My daughters, too.
Yeah, but you have a daughter. That's
that goes
up.
For my daughters,
what
too.
You mean?
I will
he's
never.
Slap
hold
up
on,
a
hold on.
Kindergarten
you
woman?
Said, I don't think you
I'm a girl.
Literally slap them. You
hold on.
Break
I
it
will
up.
Never,
pow, pow, pow,
I will
bitch.
Never. I will never condone my kid hitting first.
Same.
Okay? There's different situations. There's different
I'm saying if you are in front of two kids, one is yours, the other one slapped your kid, you're not going to be there like...
No, I'm not going to hit the kid.
Back
I'm
the fuck up.
No, I'm not going to hit the kid. I'm going to tell my kid, you either smack him.
You're going to jail.
Smack him. Yeah. Smack him back.
Now who's taking care of the kids?
That's it.
At that moment, no matter. It's me and my kid. You
hit
here?
First. But if they hit you first, you defend yourself. Now, if it's bullying and it goes on and on after I addressed it so many times, then yeah, you hit first.
Yeah. My thing is, kids are born, most of them, I don't want to say all of them, they're born innocent. They have like no malice in them.
That's
it's
yeah.
crazy. You,
and we make them evil.
This is my thing. Like, yeah,
well,
my daughter.
You don't make them evil. They're exposed to evil.
Exactly.
Because,
and that the world and the adults in it ruin kids. Kids lose their imagination, their like innocence, everything.
Even
so
more.
My thing is, you gotta, if something happens, be honest to your child. Mm-hmm. They see someone with a gun. Tell them what a gun is. Tell them
yeah,
what a gun
exactly.
does.
You have to.
It's crazy, but that's the world we live in.
You
they smell weed.
Them.
Tell them what weed is. Don't hide that.
Exactly.
Don't
and
be,
I
you can't do that. Explain
kids,
what it is
I
or whatever.
I always teach my son, especially because he's the oldest and he's a boy. If you ever feel like you did something wrong, you have to come and talk to me. I'm not going to yell at you. I'll yell at you if you didn't tell me.
Yeah.
But if you tell me and I be like, okay, now, Bobby, you did this wrong, but we'll fix it after. Let me go address it. Now, if you're not telling me and now you're lying about situations, you're going to get your ass beat.
Let me tell the woman in the room.
No, no, no. But that's
my father taught me to mind your own business.
Hold on, but that's important.
You can't mind your business. But if the business is going
to I think there's levels to it.
Yeah, but hold on. That's important that you said that you tell your son that I hope that you actually mean it. Because some parents be like, oh, you come and tell. No, I know. Some parents be like, yo, you come to me first. I'm not going to do this. And then do the opposite. Then that kid is never coming to
yeah,
you again.
Yeah, no, and then the trust is gone.
Yeah, the trust is gone. So stand
so
what
then
you
then
say.
Not only that, your kid is afraid of you.
Yeah.
Bitch. You can't have that because who's going to have... At the end of the day, I'm going to cut my head off for my kids, period. You know what I'm saying? So, next subject.
I love it.
Yeah, we brought the mama out.
Listen.
Yeah, mama bear. Papa bear, too.
I think
you
it's
love
different.
Your child,
I
you're going to
okay,
do everything
so
for them.
Talking about that, I think it's different. Yeah, papa bear is papa bear, but as a mom... It's a little bit more.
Yeah,
like
you carried that kid, everything.
Exactly.
You made
we
that kid.
The one that suffered the pain. We the one that had the mixed emotions. We felt the baby move.
You're lucky AJ's sleeping because he would have said something.
You would have forced it.
I'm wide awake.
He said, I can get 50 females pregnant. Well, y'all can be pregnant once.
He said, you got 9 months.
That's crazy.
Let me get in here. Listen.
Go. The one time I decided to chill out.
Yeah, just chill, bro. Chill.
She's coming at me.
Chill, bro.
Bro, you sleeping? You ain't chilling.
Listen,
I'm awake.
He's taking a cat nap.
All right, DJ, go.
All right. At what age does promoting alcohol on your Instagram story, Snapchat story, YouTube story, Facebook story, Snapchat story, all the platforms in the world, is it not cool to promote this alcohol lifestyle that no one gives a fuck about anymore?
If they don't give a fuck, then.
Yeah. No, they don't give a fuck, but you.
I don't think it's cool promoting it, yeah.
We're talking about different generations. Now, you could be 9 years old and you'd be like, oh, look, I got my. You know what I'm saying? Back then.
And they do it for the hype, like, probably not even drinking it.
Exactly.
But what's the difference from a 40-year-old man popping bottles at the club still posting popping bottles at the club? I've seen it.
There's no difference. I'm just saying, like,
I mean, to each its own, brother.
If it helps them feel better, do it.
If they're happy like that.
It better not be a 6-year-old posting that. First off, why you got social media? Second, why you got a bottle in your hand?
Right, exactly. Where's your mom?
Yeah, my thing is, once you're legal, I don't care.
God damn, tomorrow, everybody
in general. You said
age. Yeah.
What age? So tell me what age you stop promoting.
Once you're legal age to drink.
You stop promoting that you're drinking?
No. If you're happy and that's what you do, bro, and then you never stop. If you're 99, you like going to the club and you like popping a bottle.
And you like posting it on your Snapchat, do it.
Listen, I know alcoholics that don't post that they're drinking every single day, and I know people that are not alcoholics that just post a Corona for no reason. I'm like, bro,
I think people just post it to people just post it to pretend that they're having a good time. That's their current lifestyle,
It's for clout.
Like back in the day, you know, I used to pop bottles. If I'm popping bottles, I'm gonna post my photo. You know what I'm saying? Because I spent $300 on a motherfucking bottle.
You see, I do it sometimes. I don't do it all the time, and it depends on my mood. I'm like, all right, let me just post it to post. I don't even check who views my story anymore. Right. I don't care.
Right.
I post it to post it.
But you're posting it for who?
For myself. I felt like I wanted to post it, so I posted it.
You want to go back to women and how they post Instagram photos?
I don't do that. I'm not that type of person.
So who you posting for?
Myself. You will never see me post half naked pictures, you would never in lingerie or whatever. I post what I want to post, but it's never anything disrespecting me.
That's why you're wifed up.
That's why you're wifey, he said.
Nobody wants to talk about that, though.
No, a lot of people, that's my thing. People have birthday photo shoots.
It's because they can't hear you.
You can talk about it.
It's because a lot of people don't want to talk about that shit because
they can't hear you.
All right, whatever. Realistically, that's why you're wifed up. That's why you're happy. That's why you got a family.
That's why you're not from the streets.
I'm not.
With three baby daddies.
You're not posting, you know, crazy shit. You're not showing your body. You're not bugging out on the social media.
Take some advice, DJ. You showing your nipples out there. That's why you're single.
And your forearms too much.
You think so?
Fact. And you tell bitches that you got 30 seconds in and you're...
Yeah, they like that shit. And I eat them out for an hour. You don't eat out, so I don't know why you're trying to come at me for.
He said that's all he does.
That's all,
with your gochin.
That's what they like. It tickles a bone.
I have something. It's kind of, it's not serious. It's corny, but it's something.
Say it with your chest.
What's your pet peeve? I'm going to name three. All right. One thing that I don't like is that my shower curtain got to be closed.
Yep. Okay? I agree.
When no one's in the shower?
Has to be down.
Yeah,
yes.
It has to be closed. Fuck? Even after you take a shower, shut that shit. Two, the toilet seat got to be closed.
The
toilet paper gotta be a certain way.
It has to be over.
Yeah. What about gender neutrality?
I got one that came up to mind for me. You know what I hate as a pet peeve? Is those people that use those shoes as sandals and they fuck the shoes up. Yo, I hate that shit. I don't know if you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They got sneakers and
the
use them as sandals.
The
back and wear it.
I hate that shit so much.
Another pet peeve. Yo, shirts have to be by color. Underwear has to be by style. Bras have to be by color. When I do the dishes, everything has to be organized nicely.
What's by color?
You talking about underwear needs to be by color?
No. Underwear has to be by... No.
What does that mean?
He uses one type of underwear.
What does that mean?
What do you mean?
By color.
You said underwear got to be by color.
My closet.
Are you talking about...
I have it all organized by color. All
right, so you're talking about underwear. Underwear for you.
Yeah, because all his shit is boxers.
Okay.
But it still has to be folded neatly.
Right.
All right, but what I'm saying is, like, can I wear whatever boxes I want?
Yeah, you wear whatever you want. Or, like, When you go to put them away, they better be organized.
Do men fold their underwear?
I fold
my
underwear.
I fold
that shit in the box. AJ, you fold your underwear?
I don't fold shit.
Ain't nobody fold no underwear.
I fold his laundry.
If oh, he said you do laundry. It. Yeah, but that
if
makes
I
no
have
sense.
A man and when I did have a man.
You folded our underwear?
Absolutely. His boxers, yes.
Bro, they're flimsy. They just no, you can all just no, stick like punch it into a whole fucking drawer.
Another pet peeve.
And the socks too.
When you go to make a sandwich, clean up the crumbs.
Yes.
Up. Clean that shit up. Even if you don't think they're there, they are there. Grab something and clean them up.
That's crazy. You sound picky.
No, I think I just have OCD on my end. I don't think I'm picky. I have OCD.
I'm not even going to lie. It's a little bit OCD on my end.
Listen, and I've learned to deal with it because sometimes Fidel puts the toilet paper like under... Is that me?
That's AJ with the headset.
No, sometimes he puts the toilet seat under, and the toilet paper under, and I let it go. I'm like, it's
under
not
what?
That big of it. Like, it's the roll instead of being over, it's under. I let him. I'm like, it's whatever.
Yeah,
it's
but that's something. That's a trick you need to learn. That you waste less toilet paper if you do it a certain.
No,
situation.
No, you waste the same.
No, it doesn't.
I think it's just aesthetic for me.
If you go, if it's under like this, it will roll all the way down. If it goes over, it will slap.
Yeah, if you're
you
grabbing
still,
it, like
but
a
you can still grab the.
No, it will snap every single.
The amount is there.
When you go to wipe yourself, you gotta kind of like if it's face backwards, you gotta kind of like.
Yeah.
Roll it and then try to get it when it's on the outside.
What the fuck are we talking about now?
This is girl talk. I don't know.
You guys fold or?
Another pet peeve, yo, if you wash your hair or if you shave,
gotta start it.
Pick that shit, like clean the shower. Yes. Pick that shit up.
Rinse
in the shower?
Yes.
Yes.
So, if I shave, whatever's left.
What are you shaving, bro?
Left.
There's nothing on your fucking
clean
face.
That up. Clean that up.
Let the shower run. What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, pull it out. Stand up. Pull it out and come out right now. Stand up.
All right, blessings and lessons.
Now, hold up.
Now,
listen.
Okay, go.
Oh, were you going to say something?
I was going to say, what's your main goal right now for each of you?
That's a good question.
Make some money.
Where are we starting?
And get some bitch
I'll
pregnant.
Start.
Women, my love.
My main goal is to be trying to work on how I communicate.
With others, with your partner, with your kids?
Everything. Especially with my kids. It's harder with my kids because they're little. And I feel like, you know, because I'm a mom, I got that authority. But no, I have to learn that. I have to talk to them.
Not
always yell at them. And then even with people, sometimes I tend to raise my voice a little bit. Or, you know, like I need to read more books, basically.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's
education is key. Read more books.
100%.
Read more books.
And people be like, oh, I'm not trying to cut off the topic, but people be like, oh, who reads books? No.
You need to. If you ain't reading and doing research, what are you doing? You're not learning.
Yeah. And reading books, you could learn new words that you don't even know.
And my thing, yeah, people can tell you stuff. Go check it out. Go read about it.
Exactly, exactly, yeah.
AJ, what's your biggest goal?
Yeah, big dog.
We can't hear you.
Come on.
I'll be out here just trying to get to the paper.
Yo, AJ, you started talking loud. Now your mask off.
I'll be here talking to the paper. I'll be out here just trying to get to the paper.
I'll be out here, you know, saying light skin and shit, you know, trying to get bitches.
Never that. Never trying to get bitches. Nah, for me, it's just trying to get to the paper.
I have something at
wherever the paper's at. This time. That's where I'm at.
Hit him, Destiny. What you got?
All right. Would you rather have love or money?
Money,
because you know what? One day... You could wake up and decide you don't love me no more. But guess what?
When I
wake up and decide that this Ben Franklin is still a Ben Franklin.
You see?
That's still a Ben Franklin.
Yeah, but you see, hold on.
You might go down, though.
I pick love.
Yeah, I pick love, too. You see?
But I also feel like money has something to do with it because without money, you don't live.
Yeah,
but 100%. Love stays for there forever. Money,
it doesn't.
Yeah, with family,
it doesn't. You know why it doesn't stay forever? It's because you could wake up one day and decide you don't love me no
you
more.
You think in relationship?
But when I, but yeah. when
but
I,
you can decide to love
when,
the person every all right, day.
I feel
but
you.
What am I loving yourself?
All right, cool. But when I wake up, a Ben Franklin is still a Ben Franklin. It don't matter what day it is. It could be a Tuesday, a Wednesday. It could be five years, 10 years, 20 years down the line. That Ben Franklin is still a Ben Franklin.
Wait till you're really in love, bro.
Right.
Yeah, like I'm saying, every time
I'm in love.
Nah, listen. Yeah,
yes,
I pick love because say your son goes in a situation, bro, where
they need money.
No, where no money's going to save him, like that John Q shit movie. He had to do. There's no heart out there.
No one's out there for you.
Money would have saved him. If he was Jay-Z rich, money would have saved him.
Facts.
But he wasn't. He was on low. He was low on the tolling pole, which is why he didn't get that transplant. Yeah. But I guarantee you, if Blue Ivy needed some shit, she gonna get that shit right away.
No, look at Bronny.
Who the fuck is Bronny?
LeBron James' son. He was playing basketball.
Nigga, I'm gonna tell you straight up. Nobody want to hear this shit. If we get canceled, we get canceled.
If you get
canceled, I'm gonna tell you right now.
That's my thing. You have cancer. I'm gonna tell you right now.
All right. For 40 years, I just seen the matter of fact. I'm gonna pull up the stats.
Who's 40 years? Anyways, next question.
Fuck that shit. She brought something up.
You don't have the stats.
She brought something up, so I'm gonna bring it up. I'm gonna bring it up right now.
Hurry up, we're waiting.
I still choose love.
I choose love. That's what I'm saying.
Congratulations, you chose love.
Congratulations, you chose money.
Damn, yo.
Yep.
I chose money too.
We can tell you ain't got love in that heart, bro. All
right.
You need love.
From 1996 to 2004. These are just athletes. Just athletes.
Yeah.
From 1996 to 2004. How many years is that? Damn near 40.
To 2004, 1996? You're bugging. That's, like eight years. That's 8 years.
Sorry, 1966.
Yeah, right. Okay.
No, 1960.
Yeah, like,
all right.
Like 38 years.
All right. So 1966 to 2004.
Yep, 38
years. 38
years.
Cool. 1,101 divorces? Athletes. No, 1,101 athletes had a fatal cardiac event.
What's that got to do with divorces?
Hold on. 1,101.
Or Brownie.
That's from 66 to 2004. From 2021 to 2022, 1,114.
Are you an athlete? Do you suffer heart problems?
If I was an athlete, I would. Probably.
I get what you're saying.
We ain't seeing what happened to DeMar Hamlin. What happened to Bronny James? We wasn't seeing that back then. We're talking about 40.
So you're saying if they had money, they could have fixed it?
No. What I'm saying is we're talking about 40 years worth of statistics equal less.
Okay.
Hold on. Not even the same amount.
Put them off now. Less. I wanted to hear it.
Hold on. No. Less fatal heart event than 2001, 2022. It's the vaccines. Nobody wants to talk about this shit. This shit's a vaccine.
Okay, that's cool.
But vaccines. Hold on, where did that come from?
You know why you do? Because the book told you so.
Listen. But I guarantee you, if Bronny was to die, LeBron James would trade all that money he has to save his son.
Okay, but I bet you if he looked back on it, he wouldn't let his son get that vaccine.
But if you have money and you don't love the person because you don't have love, what would you care?
He's not going to let his son get that vaccine.
Fuck the vaccine.
No.
Why are we talking about vaccines?
I'm talking about if Bronny was to die.
He's saying vaccines cause cancer, heart disease, everything else. It makes no sense.
All right, but there's, hold on. In 1 year, there's more athletes suffering from fatal heart events.
Because they use their heart more.
In the last 40 years.
All right, next question.
Yeah. Ain't no next question. It's what it is. But nobody wants to pay attention to that shit. At the end of the day, we don't know the repercussions or the side effects of these vaccines.
All right, guys, we're going to lesson or blessing. We're done for the day. Who wants to start? Lesson or blessing of the week? You can either choose a lesson or a blessing that you had this week.
I got a lesson. Listen.
A blessing.
Oh, you going right to left?
My daughter just turned 2.
Can you say that?
That's a blessing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, you go with you. We're going this way.
All right, so lesson or blessing for this week. All right, so lesson or blessing for this week. Me personally, talking for me, time matters. Time matters. I'm going to say that only because right now I'm juggling 4 different jobs. And for me, it's just, oh, shit, the paper. And then I realized the last 2 days, so today's Friday. So Thursday and Friday, I didn't see my son awake. When I say awake, I mean when I left my crib in the morning, he was sleeping. When I got back to my crib at nighttime, he was sleeping. And that was yesterday and today. So 2 days in a row, I didn't see my son awake. And that's when I realized, like, sometimes the paper really ain't worth it.
Okay, contradicted yourself.
Mm-hmm. Big time.
Okay. I mean,
but no, I respect it. Yeah, I agree with you 100%.
I mean, so for me, the lesson of the blessing is just, I realize sometimes it, the paper ain't worth it.
So that goes back to love or money?
Love, you see. Right? Love. Love. That's different. That's completely different. We talking it's relationships, love. Or we talking about your...
Love to your kids, that's to a relationship, whoever. Bro. Family, whoever.
Yeah, that's a relationship.
We talking about your with your significant other
anyone. Love in general.
Love, bro. You got love for your kid?
Absolutely.
That's love, bro. Your headphones. That's love, bro. All right, I'm gonna go with me then. Lesson or blessing of the week. I think I'm more of a lesson this week. I feel like God is sending me situations where I need to be uncomfortable to make me comfortable.
That's
so. Cause there's shit that I don't even know. Some days I don't even know where I'm at, to be honest. But I'm taking it day by day, and I'm still here. So,
amen.
My lesson is get the fuck away from the mic, AJ. My lesson is sometimes you work so goddamn hard for something that you want, and it's not your time. And I realize that because you're working so hard, in the future that's just gonna come and hit you back 10 times harder than what you expected.
Damn, I got 2 lessons. My first one is that you don't really live a moment twice. And then the second one is say what you mean without being mean.
Ooh. Okay.
That's a bar. Say what you mean.
That was nice.
Say what you mean without being mean. Okay.
You heard it.
Fuck with that.
DJ, you got to take some advice from that.